everyone, welcome back to the Astro Room, your very own portal to the cosmos. And in this video, I'm going to show you what I feel is an exact identical tripod head to what ZWO C-Star is currently selling, but at half the price. So right now, the C-Star wedge, as of the date of this video, is about $80 US, if you can get it, depending on where you live at the moment. But this one that I found is half the price. It's about $40 US. Now, keep in mind that the reason why I think this is almost identical, pretty much almost exactly the same one that they're offering, is because I checked the specifications and it's pretty much the exact same specifications that they have. It also carries a payload of 5 kilograms, which is basically 11 pounds. And it's pretty much the same weight also that theirs is. So that's the reason why I am letting everyone know about it. Not only that, but I've tested it as well. That doesn't mean that the Skywatcher wedge is not an awesome wedge. This is a great wedge. If you don't know much about this wedge, or you're looking to get also another type of tripod head or wedge, that one is also great. Check out my video if you haven't seen it already on how to use that wedge and how to do equatorial mode. I'll leave a link in the description and right up here so you can watch that on your own time. But what I want to mention also, guys, is that in no way, once again, this is not sponsored. This is something that I bought on my own and just want to recommend it to others. So I'll put a link in the description. Now, this tripod head is very easy to use. And when you get it, it'll actually come with two of these quick release plates. But you're going to want to use the bigger one if you're going to use it for your C-Star. It will also come with this little adapter, which my understanding is it's a 3/8 screw adapter. And my understanding is that ZWO's also comes with an adapter. So let me show you exactly how to use this. And also just know that this is a very, what I think is very quality, of a quality feel. And it's a good weight. It's small, super tiny, but it does the job. It does the job. Before I start, I wanted to mention something interesting that I was looking at my YouTube analytics and noticed that over 55% of you that come to my channel over and over again are not subscribed. So do me a favor right now, hit the like button and subscribe, because not only is it free, but that actually lets me know that you want to continue seeing more videos from the Astro Room. You enjoy this content, that you find it valuable, and you want to see more. So hit the like button and subscribe. Let me show you how to mount this. So what I'm going to do is put my adapter, or the adapter that it came with, the 3/8 screw adapter, I'm going to put it in the C-Star first. You can use a little wrench to put that in there. Make sure it's nice and tight. Now I'm going to grab the quick release plate. Make sure that's nice and tight as well. All right, we're good to go. Now, when you get this tripod head, this actually comes in pieces. What I mean is that this is actually not attached. This comes unattached, but you just go ahead and hook it on there. Okay, so just to let you know, once you get it, that part is separate. But it comes with it, but it's separate. Now, also, when you get your tripod head, you will notice that that adapter, the 3/8 screw, is actually already going to be in here. So it's going to be in here screwed in. So just keep that in mind. You might feel like, oh no, it didn't come with the adapter. It is, it's in there. So just unscrew it, take it out, and that's what you're gonna put in your C-Star, okay? So one thing that I did that actually was a bit of an issue is that this knob that's here, it's actually interfering with the C-Star tripod. This is the C-Star stock tripod, the S50 tripod, and it's interfering with this. So I ended up having to use a different knob that will stick out to be able to adjust that right there. But I actually took it from light stand that I had, and it just happened to fit. But I also had another screw that fit it as well. You're going to make sure you loosen this knob right here, okay? And then you can slide in your C-Star. Now, will this work for the S50? We're going to test that as well. Let me make sure I tighten this really well. This is really, this is perfect. Look at how far that goes down. Okay. So this should be enough for most of you, depending on where you live, right? Your latitude. But this works great for me where I am. I'm in Southern California. Now, I have a really cool tip for you to test at home that a lot of people don't know about that is in your C-Star app for you to test equatorial mode inside your home. So I'm on EQ mode, as you can see there on the app. And all I need to do now is, I was making sure this was tightened. Okay, it is now. Is loosen this knob right here and put it to what it tells me, right? It's which is 34 degrees latitude for my location. So yeah, as you can see, it's very simple to use. It's got a great handle here. Let me put this on the side so you can see it better. Very sturdy. Very, very sturdy. It holds the weight really, really well. I'm actually tilting it all the way down now, but it holds the weight really well. Of course, you can move this side to side as well, right? Once you have it set, you just want to make sure you lock it so it won't move anywhere. Now, how can I test if this actually won't fall, for instance? Let's say you're worried that it's going to fall. Well, in your C-Star app, if you go under your advanced features under demonstration mode, it has a random go-to setting. Turn that on and check it out. It's doing this completely hands-free on its own. It's kind of like it's simulating in any direction, pretending that it's going to do, like, let's say a polar aligned deviation. It's going to be turning around, moving around, complete 360 for as long as you need it to. So really, really cool. It'll also stop and then it'll start again. And it's going to be doing that continuously for as long as you leave that feature on. It's pretty neat. So once you're done using it, I would wait for it to stop and then turn off the random go-to. And now there you go. It's going to stay at that exact spot. So what about our S50? Is it going to work on the S50? So I'm going to bring it all the way back and do a random go-to again, a test. Can it hold the weight? Can it hold the weight of the S50? Now, as I had mentioned, this can hold up to 11 pounds, this tripod head, right? And the C-Star S50 is only a little over 5.5 pounds. So let's see. Okay, so I'm doing the random go-to. It's going to do it all on its own. Let's see what happens. Let's see if it doesn't fall. Remember, the whole point of this is to make sure that when you're doing it inside your home, then you can do it outside. You know it'll be safe out there for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 hours. So far, so good. Doing complete rotations. What I want to do now is move it up a little bit because I have it all the way down. Let me move it up a little bit to see if it'll hold the weight. All right, hands-free. It's still moving around. I think it's going to hold. Now, what I'm thinking also is that if you're concerned that it won't hold, I would put a sandbag or a weight on it. Now, when I read what CWO said about their own tripod head, they actually told people that this is totally okay for either the S30 or the S50. So I'm trusting that it's going to work. And it seems to work just fine. I don't see it falling. I'm paying attention to what degrees I had put it on. And it hasn't moved a bit. I tightened it really well. It seems to do the job. If you are overly concerned, I would still recommend the Skywatcher wedge instead. But just because this holds way more weight, right? But it seems like it'll be fine. Another thing that I noticed about this company is that the one that sells the tripod head is that they actually specialize in selling tripod heads of different kinds plus tripods for all kinds of things. So it seems to be a reputable company. Let me know what you think. Let me know what kind of wedge are you using? What's worked out well for you? Are you using something similar? Did you already get the ZWO tripod head that they're offering? How is that one working out for you? Do you prefer the Skywatcher wedge instead? Let me know in the comments. Let me know what you think about it. I'm going to say I feel confident. I feel comfortable using the S50 on this tripod head. I like it.